Have you ever noticed the water in your bathtub spinning as it goes down the drain? This is known as a vortex. In this particular vortex, the water spirals around and forms a funnel shape, which looks a lot like another funnel-shaped vortex, the tornado. Today, we'll be recreating the bathtub vortex in a bottle. And because it looks like one, this science activity is also known as tornado in a bottle. Want to see how to make one? Then let's get scienced. To make a tornado in a bottle, you'll need two clear 2-liter bottles and something to connect them together. Either duct tape and a 25mm washer, a hot glue gun and a 5cm long piece of PVC pipe, thin enough to fit inside the bottle, or a purpose-built bottle connector. I've placed a link for this one in the description. You don't actually need to connect the two bottles together. If you only have one bottle, or if you don't have any of the connectors, you can still create the vortex by filling the bottle with water until it's 3/4 full, turning it upside down, make sure you do this outside or over a bowl, and swirling the bottle around. Of course, if you do this, you will need to refill the bottle each time. So let's look at three different ways to connect two bottles together. For each of these, start by filling one of the bottles with water until it's 3/4 full. The first way of connecting the bottles together involves placing a washer on top of the bottle filled with water, balancing the empty bottle on top of this washer, and tightly taping the two bottles together with duct tape. The second way of connecting the bottles together involves pushing and twisting half of the PVC pipe into the bottle filled with water, then adding some glue where the PVC pipe touches the top of the bottle, and pushing and twisting the empty bottle onto the PVC pipe until the two bottles meet. You might want to add some duct tape to this one as well to hold it all in place. The third way of connecting the bottles together involves twisting the connector onto each bottle, first the one filled with water and then the empty bottle. No matter how you make it, they all create a similar vortex when you swirl the bottle around. Awesome! This looks pretty cool already, but I have four ideas that should make it look even cooler. Idea 1, adding 10 drops of food coloring to the water. Idea 2, adding some glitter to the water. Idea 3, adding some glow-in-the-dark powder to the water. And idea 4, filling the bottle with tonic water instead of regular water and using a UV light to make it glow. Let me know which one you liked best, and if you tried anything else for your tornado in a bottle. So what's happening? When we turn the bottles around, gravity pulls water from the top bottle into the bottom bottle. As it does this, air moves up to take its place. Right now we're getting a lot of bubbles, but if we give it a spin, the water starts spinning and a vortex forms. The center of the vortex is kind of like a straw. It allows a steady flow of air to move up through the middle and a steady flow of water to move down along the sides. Also, check out what happens if you gently rock the bottle back and forth while the vortex is spinning. Wow! If you didn't give it a spin, you might have noticed some of the water stayed in the top bottle, even though there's space for it in the bottom bottle. What? That's because water molecules are really good at holding on to each other. And also because the air around the bottle pushes up on this layer of water and holds it back. But we'll look at this a bit more in a future video. That's all for today. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time on Silly Science with Simon.